Okay, Mike, please welcome you here to Dublin. I'm a big fan of your work. At TechCrunch in Europe, I mean, I've been watching some of your movements. You're paying a lot of attention to what's going on in Germany, for example. You're holding workshops in the mornings in Berlin, for example, in restaurants. Your view on the startup scene in Europe, I mean, everything seems to gravitate towards Silicon Valley, but I've met people like Niklas Zennström last year from Skype who said that it isn't all about Silicon Valley.
No, it's not. I mean, I think the point about being in the Valley is that you have access to a very large market, which is America. But the clever thing about a lot of European startups is they distribute their power, as it were, across the globe. You can have your developers in Kiev, your CEO in London or Dublin, or your venture capital from anywhere in Europe. And if you can have boots on the ground, as it were, in the US, then all to the good. Especially for English language-based companies coming out of Ireland and the UK, it makes a lot of sense to do that.
In terms of the kind of companies that you're seeing, I mean, I'm very enthusiastic about some of the Irish companies. I think there's great promise here, but I think there's the same problems across the world in terms of access to venture capital. How do you surmise the deal flow that's happening in Europe versus elsewhere in the world? I mean, everyone talks about how easy it is to get money in venture capital in, say, Silicon Valley, but if you're in London or Dublin or Paris, how would you surmise the deal flow that's going on at the moment?
Well, the thing about raising funds in Europe is that you have to be smart as a European entrepreneur. A lot of European entrepreneurs are not used to the fact that they might need to get several term sheets and eventually get on a plane and basically get out there, go to London, go to Dublin, go to Stockholm, wherever, go to Berlin and look for funding from any source you can find. It is entirely possible. I think the other thing that's going on is that there are new funds being created at a much lower level. For instance, in London recently, there was a company, a venture capital company called Passion Capital, which recently launched with £37 million of fund, and with government backing, boosted that up to a much higher figure. So, with matched funding, and I think European governments are starting to realise that if they legislate in a particular manner, then these smaller funds can be created with matched funding. Now, that means that you don't actually need nearly as much money as you used to do a technology startup. So it makes more sense for these smaller funds to exist. The bigger funds, the bigger venture capital funds in Europe have moved more slowly, more ponderously. It's almost like they have an albatross around their neck. They have to look for it forces them to look for later stage deals. So I think things are changing, and if you look at what's happening in the US, they're looking for deal flow outside the US. You get people like Dave McClure coming from 500 startups coming out to the Europe to basically look for deal flow, and it's fascinating what's going on, and they're looking for deal flow in Europe quite substantially, a lot of them.
Attitude has a lot to do with a startup. People start up companies out of either they have to or they want to, and often in Ireland, one of the things we need to deal with a lot is people's attitude to failure. Do you think that Europe has many different jurisdictions and many different attitudes, different ways of dealing with things, but in general, Europeans' approach to failure, do you think that's changing, or do you think there's a lot of work to be done?
I think it's a generational shift. So I think if you looked 10 years ago, societies across Europe, if we want to talk in general terms, are generally a little bit down on that. But I think a couple of things have happened. The new wave of technology, plus the recession, has meant that there are no jobs now at BMW in Munich you can't just go and get a corporate job. So to some extent, it does force you to think in an entrepreneurial manner. And that means that your friends are just going to have to get used to the fact that some of your stuff is going to fail. And their stuff is going to fail, and you're just going to have to slap each other on the back and say, pick yourself up and do it again. So it's a generational shift. I mean, I see people today in their 20s who are just like, doing a company for a couple of years or, doing something for a while and then realizing it's not working and pivoting in a different direction. And I think people are just getting used to that fact now. If you want to talk in terms of jurisdictions, I think jurisdiction-wise, both Ireland and the UK have the most, I think, regulatory simple ways of closing, you know, building a company, and then if you've got it wrong, you know, can close it, start again, do something new. And there are other, you know, there are other good ones in Europe as well. I think it's more restrictive in places like Germany and then France. But very interestingly, because of the European Union, you can now set up companies in other jurisdictions and just stay in wherever you are. Stay in Berlin. Stay where in, you know, stay in Stockholm. So there is ways around it. You just have to be smart.
Mike, thank you very much.